It's a harsh reality that some children throughout the United States, including right here in Keloland, are exposed to domestic violence. The Compass Center is dedicated to breaking this cycle of violence, and there are plenty of ways that you can show your support, including participating in one of the Compass Center's biggest fundraising events of the year. Jennifer Adler and Michelle Trent are with the Compass Center, and they're here to tell us about their upcoming gala event. They also brought along auctioneer Jonathan Larson to teach us how to get active in a live auction without taking home a $20,000 sailboat by accident. All right, welcome all of you. Thanks for coming in today.
Thank you.
So, Michelle, let's just start off by talking about the Compass Center. Just give us a quick background about your mission.
Yeah, so the Compass Center's mission is to break the cycle of violence for those who experience it. And so we work with families and children, men and women who have experienced sexual assault or domestic violence. All of our services are free, hence the need for a fundraiser.
So, Jennifer, let's talk about this gala now and what all happens. This is the 11th year of doing it.
So for 10 years, we had an event called It's in the Bag. We changed the name this year and changed up our format a little bit. We moved it from a Tuesday night to a Friday night so that people can let their hair down and kind of enjoy it a little bit more. We have live and silent auction items. We have heads tails raffle. We have a golden ticket. We have free wine and beer samples from our wine bar and Severance Brewing Company. And then we have Good Road playing live music and a full set after the auction is done.
Sounds like a great night to me for a great cause. Michelle, just tell us where these proceeds go.
Yeah, so all of our proceeds go to the Compass Center to provide free services. So when you bid to the Compass Center, when you donate to the Compass Center, all of those are allowing families and children and adults to get free counseling services, free advocacy services. It's allowing us to go to court with them. It's allowing us to help them on their long-term healing journey.
All right, well, Jonathan, you are an auctioneer, and you are going to be the auctioneer for this event.
I am.
Now, I've actually never participated in a live auction before, so I want you to teach me how to do this. It's kind of intimidating.
It is a little intimidating because a lot of people, they see it on TV and they see the cattle auctioneers just rattling off. They don't know where they're at. Are they at $200, $2,000, or $200,000? So people are a little bit intimidated by it. So what we do is we give everybody these cards. It could be a paddle, it could be a card. For our sake, it's these cards. And I just have everybody just kind of get used to waving them before I get started, just to get used to raising your hand. Because a lot of people, they're in a comfort zone. They don't want to do it. So what I like to see is when I'm rattling off numbers, so if I'm like $200, but not three, $300, but not four, not four, not four, $100, but not three, $100, but not four. And I will stop and let people know, like, okay, you're at 300. Now I'm looking for four. The way I like people to bid is I like them to be enthusiastic and jump up there and wave it, to feel good about what they're doing because they are actually saving a life, impacting a life, or doing really good. We're not buying a cow here. We're having fun. We're saving lives. And so I want them to do that. There are some people that don't want their friends at the other table to know they're bidding against them because they're just bidding them up, and they'll just do a finger.
Why
or something
is that?
Like.
Why would you not want them to know?
A lot of times at cattle auctions, it's because they don't want them to drive up the prices. They don't want them to know who's interested. At fundraisers, it's because they're trying to make them pay a lot more. And they don't
so
want them to know it's them.
Like,
yeah.
Right here.
Sometimes they get together and they're like, oh, I know it's you. And then I can get them to go back and forth even more. But for the most part, raise your hand. It feels so good. It's like you're winning. And I can help people win here on Friday night. They can walk away with winners.
And that's how you end up spending a lot of money. Because
it is.
Almost becomes like a game, and you want to be the winner, even though you're the one who's spending the money.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Right?
Correct. Your last hand up wins.
Okay. So if I were to do like a little thing with my nose, would you count that at a fundraising event?
It depends. If you're being funny about it, absolutely I would. I also, if somebody's texting on their phone and being obnoxious about that, and I know I can get away with it, I'll let that be a bit as well, and I'll tell them I'm doing it just to have that interaction and that fun.
Okay.
But sometimes people are waving at other people and just like, ah, like that, and I'm just do it, and then the crowd gets, they have a great time with it, and then they feel bad, and if they accept the bid, I'll let them take it. If not, then I just move on and lessons learned kind of a thing.
So we have one item right here. And this is a gorgeous diamond necklace. So we're just going to pretend to bid for this. Not real money.
Not real
not
money.
Not actually pin.
Although it would be a good donation to the Compass Center.
Right.
It would be.
That's right.
So we just start out at $100. So I'll be like, I start everything out at $100, or not at $100, but I start out everything with the bid just because I'm not asking for it. So let's say, I'll just say, I have $100. $100, but now two, now two, now two, two. $100, but now three. I'm $300, $400, but now five. I'm $500, but now $600, but now seven. $600, $700, but now eight. $700, but now eight, now eight, now eight. $100, but eight. Your turn. $800, but now nine. It's fake money. $900, but now 1,000. Sold it to you for $900. Yay. See, now you feel good. You gotta keep going then. You just keep your hand up there the whole time.
But so this could keep going for a long time.
Yeah. It could, but I would jump the bids up higher. Like on a piece like this, I probably wouldn't start at $100, but there are instances where people, they start everything at $100 because that's where they're comfortable, and then I end up going up into the thousands. It's just the long way, but I can do it. Yeah. So.
Well, this is awesome. You're great, Jonathan. Let's get to the specifics now. Jennifer, if you just want to give us the details for those who want to attend the event.
Sure. So you can get your tickets online. We still have some available. It's www.thecompasscenter.org/events. Tickets are $50. That covers your plated dinner, your free samples, the concert with Good Road. Gives you the chance to sit in on the auction and witness all of this live. It's going to be a great night.
Sounds like it. I just had fun learning how to do that. Now I'm going to be able to participate in the live auction. All right, thank you all so much for coming in today and telling us all about this.
Thank you.
Thank you.